この超えるべきものがある強さを一つ二つ壁を壊すたび試されるのさ本気のカード奇跡掴み取るんだその先に何がある正解さえも間違いさえもない自由すぎるこの空で僕らは探し続けるんだただ一つの道をそうきっと明日さえも見えないジグザグな足跡でも僕らは描き合おうさ
It's finally here! The second anniversary of the Anime Otoku All-Star Channel. I'm here today to give you some things. I know some of you guys saw the first round of the Anime Otoku All-Star Tournament of Anime, and you guys are waiting for or Joker from Persona 5 versus Diablo from How to Not Summon Demon Lord. And yes, I'm doing a similar thing to Cartoon Fight Club, Death Battle, or when they reveal their next characters who will be facing each other. But since I don't have the budget to put high quality fight, like say, make the characters fight each other every time. So we all know this trend that is happening on YouTube, like Crab Cup? Yeah, that's what you guys were seeing. But I'm not doing shorts. Or that, and I know some people who love the In Another World with my smartphone is pissed that their boy, Kirito? Oh wait. There's two bastards who has a similar hairstyle. Oh, and I know you guys are about to say something like, where is how to fix the isekai genre? Well, don't worry. I'm still working on it. And also, I'm still going to make videos. It was like the comics, shows, and the other things. And also, I decided to go back to watch the reboot Saint Seiya series. Yep, the series that was on Netflix, but for some reason Netflix doesn't have the Battle of Sanctuary arc or the Sanctuary arc. Crunchyroll has it now. And probably I know some people hated Toei for, like, some of you Saint Seiya fans out there. They're including me. Are upset that Toei decided to get rid of the classic anime. Maybe because they're still believing that the current generation, us, will not like old school anime. Like, seriously. Like, imagine you watch Ashita no Joe, a classic boxing anime, but you don't give a shit about it, because you go, why is this animation so boring? Why is the characters don't have big eyes? Where are the waifus? And stuff. Or some people watch JoJo, but they see other anime with big guys with muscles. Then we'll go like, is that a JoJo reference? But if you want more details about the origins of some of your favorite series like Rikki-Yo, JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, Dorigo, Coco Bancho, and don't forget, Seven Deadly Sins. Go check out a fellow anime YouTuber called The Anime Hero or The Manly Anime Hero. He does some content that people will like some videos on Baki the Grappler. Gurr, Ashina Joe, and so many others. Recently, I got into manly anime, thanks to series like JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, but I think the one I could consider the one that got me into seeing buff dudes beating the shit out of each other is Kengan Asura. And I didn't read the manga yet, but we... And another series that has some big, huge muscles, and damn. Is Record of Ragnarok or Senetsu no Valkyrie. And it's kind of crazy that the series is still going, but Kengan Omega, it has more chapters than there is than Record of Ragnarok. Okay, I get it, because it's in a monthly schedule. Well, because the details in the manga can rival that of Kengan, and probably surpass Baki. Like, seriously, some of the characters' muscles are bigger than Baki's. Like, take Seuss's muscles. His muscles are bigger than Biscuit Oliva. Hajun, bigger than Yujiro's. Those, and other things. But we're also getting video game adaptations of some of our favorite series. I know some people hate some of the things that people have saw, like Danganronpa the animation. Yeah, but two of these series is getting coming back again, being Tekken and Hyperdimension Neptunia. Tekken's finally getting a new anime adaptation called Tekken Bloodline, and it's probably based around the Tekken 3 story. And yes, Hyperdimension Neptunia is an anime adaptation that was... I don't know, I didn't review it yet, so probably I'll talk about it. And people still are excited for Solo Leveling getting an anime adaptation, but now let's talk about the problem that one series will get. Dragon Ball. Well, you know what, I'm just gonna keep it for its own separate video. So yeah, that's it. This is how the second anniversary of the Anime and Tokyo All-Star channel will go. Probably the next year, being the third anniversary of the channel, maybe I'll make new videos and probably do another tournament. Probably, also leave me your suggestions of who you want to see in the tournament. Probably will be Perfect Cell. Or Devil Artemis. Or anything. And probably in the next video will be how to fix the isekai genre. But I have to tell you guys this. Well, I'm going to Mexico for 2 days, I guess. Who knows, maybe I'll show you. Maybe I will have fun there. But hey, I will still upload videos there. So, see you guys next time. I don't know.